I'd like to show you some dimensional analysis, one-step dimensional analysis. I tend to not call it dimensional analysis. I think of it just as unit conversion, and I think of unit conversion as multiplication by funny-looking ones. Now, it turns out that one is something called the multiplicative identity, a word that you don't need to worry about. It just means that when you multiply a number by one, you don't change its value. There's one other piece of the puzzle that we need, and that is that when you divide a number by its equal, the result is one. Let me show you what I mean by each of these things. First of all, I'm going to number these as one and two. Number two, when you divide a number by its equal, the result is one. Here's something that happens to be true, that 1 inch is equal to 2.54 centimeters. And cm is the abbreviation for centimeter. Actually, for inch, I'm going to use 1 in, or in, as the abbreviation for inch. Now, those things happen to be equal. So this is true. 2.54 centimeters divided by 1 inch is equal to one. And that's exact. It has no units, so it's just plain one. Also, 1 inch divided by 2.54 centimeters is also equal to one. Both of those things happen to be true. A number divided by its equal is one. So it works both ways. Now that's a this right here or this right here are both funny looking ones, but they're one. And so I can multiply numbers by these and I don't change the number's value. I may change its appearance, but I don't change its value. This is the basis of being able to multiply by things like this and convert units. The units are the cm or the in. Those are what those happen to be. Okay, so let's suppose we have a length of 35 inches. And I want to convert that into centimeters for some reason. I multiply by a funny looking one, but I have to pick the appropriate funny looking one. Let's suppose I multiply by 1 inch over 2.54 centimeters. Okay, there's my funny looking one. Now, when you're dealing with units for physical quantities, treat them as algebraic things, like treat them like x's or y's or a's or b's, and so follow all the rules for those things. When you multiply an x by an x, you'd get x squared. When you multiply an inch by an inch, you get inches squared. So the top of this multiplication turns into 35 inches squared. The bottom turns into 2.54 centimeters. And if you do the math on that, you would get 14 inches squared per centimeter. That's not convenient. It happens to be correct. 35 inches does equal 14 inches squared per centimeter, but it's useless. There's no point in doing that. So don't do things like that. It doesn't get us to where we want to go. When we are converting units, we want to have the units that we're not interested in divide out. So here's the correct way to do a conversion like that. 35 inches times, I'll take the other funny looking one, 2.54 centimeters over 1 inch. Multiply by that one. Now I can see when I multiply this, I'll have an algebraic quantity, in inches on top, and the same quantity on the bottom. Those will divide out. And so I'll end up with nothing left but centimeters over here, and whatever the number happens to be. I get 89 centimeters. I'm only keeping two significant figures because I only have two to begin with. Now, I used both of these ideas here. I used the idea that when you divide a number by its equal, the result is 1. And I also used multiplication by 1 doesn't change a number's value. It just changes its appearance. So here's something that happens to be true that I found from this. 35 inches is equal to 89 centimeters. I'd like to do some unit conversions that you may not have heard of. So I'm going to switch to some other units here. In physics and astronomy, we often deal with wavelengths of light. And wavelengths of light we happen to measure in units called nanometers. Nanometers are fairly short. They happen to be a billionth of a meter. If you think of a meter as being approximately as long as your arm, a billionth of that is going to be quite short. But that's a convenient unit for measuring light. And it's a sort of scientific notation. 1 nanometer. By the way, the abbreviation for a nanometer is an nm. So 1 nanometer is equal to 1 times 10 to the minus ninth meters. There are a whole set of metric prefixes that are used in various contexts. Just that lowercase n, when it's in front of the m, you can replace that with 10 to the minus ninth, and that's what it happens to equal. Well, let me show you an example, and we'll convert from nanometers into meters. There's a wavelength of light that's given off by hydrogen. That's about 656 nanometers, and it's a bright red line or a bright red color that you can see in there. And it's a fairly common one. Often when people are studying the sun, they filter out all the light except this particular wavelength, and they can see features on the sun that aren't otherwise visible. For converting it, I'm going to use this equal thing right here. Those two things are equal, and so their ratio is equal to 1. So the funny looking 1 that I'm going to use, I've got nanometers. I'd like to divide them out. And so I'll put my 1nm down here on the bottom and my 1 times 10 to the minus ninth meters on top and multiply by that. The nm here on top divides with the nm, the nanometers on top divide with the nanometers on the bottom. And what I'd get out of this is 656 times 10 to the minus ninth meters. Now, that isn't scientific notation, so I'm going to do a little bit of work to turn that into scientific notation. 656, if I convert that to scientific notation, would become 6.56 times 10 squared. That's just the 656. I still have the times 10 to the minus ninth meters. When you multiply two bases, the tens in this case that have exponents, you add the exponents. 2 plus negative 9 would be negative 7. This becomes 6.56 times 10 to the negative 7th meters. So I can say this, 656 nanometers is equal to 6.56 times 10 to the minus 7th meters. So there's a one-step unit conversion that worked in this case.